Thank you all for being here. Thanks to Anonymous reviewers for selecting this my contribute to the National Sound Conference for Hospitality and Good Organization. For guys, for my weak English. Algorithmic composition with open music and C-sound, two examples. We start with a general introduction, and then I will speak about a few patches of mine. Well, we know that the C-sound read a text code and performs or renders an audio file. So founded on code writing, by its very nature, C-sound can be paired, coupled with software that helps to make instruments or scores, or that provided by graphic interface uses C-sound as a synthesis engine. Dave Phillips has mentioned several in his book about Linux music and sound, Hydra, Cecilia, Silence, the family of Atelier Planck composer software, and Bianchini and Cipriani, Virtual Sounds, encloses Windows software for interfacing C-sound and various Windows utilities. You can also recall score generation software, Athena CL, Serres 3, Rosegarden, Rain, C-Mask, and many others. Some are only for Linux or Unix environments, other ones are no more maintained. Today on C-Sound site, we find SoundQt, Blue, Cabbage, Unix Sound. About algorithmic composition, it can be classified according to two main categories, constructive and declarative approach. In constructive approach, the software is instructed for developing composition or audio material. In declarative approach, the software is instructed for composing an entire composition. These definitions fit very good for instrumental composition, while in electronic music, particularly according to David Cope's computer-generated sounds category, we can reside at the same time in the first or in the second and in the second category. Of course, the sound has algorithmic composition tools. Giorgio Zucco in his book gives us some interesting example, not only him, of course. And the code underlying the performance of Soul Best of Chaos and developed by Francioni can be a good example of a declarative approach. However, algorithmic composition is not the main aim of the sound. So the alliance with an algorithmic composition software such as OpenMusic appears particularly suitable. In past I have used C-Sound both writing the code and using graphic interfaces like Atelier Planck Composer C-Sound, so passing to use OpenMusic for developing instrument, C-Sound instrument score has been a natural evolution. In this screenshot, you have Atelier Planck Composer C-Sound. The user can select the frequencies for an instrument based on FM Bell opcode. I have used the software for create and developing sounds for Anagrammi, A Piece of Mind for solo flute and live electronics. Well, about open music libraries that use C-Sound, we can remember ON2C Sound by Haddad, Malta, Poitier, Bresson. It permits graphical sound instruments as score creation and management. This is a simple example from tutorials. This is a demonstrative sound, nothing of musical, about additive synthesis. This is the generated orchestra score. Another interesting library is ON4C Sound by Lanza, Berengeri and Biagioni. Unfortunately, no more available. This figure is drawn off from a paper. And we can see that probably there were a lot of open music functions parallel corresponding to C Sound opcodes. This approach was inspired George Duke realizing PWC sound, the PWL library for for using C sound in building instruments and scores inside PWGL. The other it is defined broader and enemy software of music. OM Chroma by Stroppa Bresson Bidin makes large use of matrices for managing parameters and has the possibility to import personal instruments. Here you have examples from tutorials, first three for additive synthesis, last one for FOF synthesis. First demonstrative sound with frequency deviations. Second sample with vibrato frequency variations. Some sounds with different envelopes. Last example, FOF synthesis with different filter settings. Stroppa used Amsterdam's sound computer instrument catalog instruments, these two ones for additive synthesis, for example, this one for FOF synthesis. And this is the C-sound file, generated C-sound file with the instrument and the score. On Prisma by Marlon Schumacher is devoted to sound spatialization using C-sound. This is a simple example from tutorial in a stereo environment. This is the orchestra. I will scroll in a very fast manner the code because in the end I will give you the references for downloading if you want, of course, this slides from my courses site. And the sound file has a user-defined opcodes and the score. This is another example, a simple rotation example. We can listen to it inside OpenMusic. And last a library that uses C-sound is ShantLib by Michon. It's the IRCAM Shant synthesizer implementation into C-sound. This is a really very simple sound, only to have an idea. This is the orchestra file inside the ShantLib folder. It's a very complex file. It's used, of course, for rendering the sound. If you download the library inside the folder, you find this file and the score generated by this example. Now I can pass it to describe two patches of mine. This first patch was used in composing Balenopter, a piece for bass clarinet, electronic sound, sounds and live electronics, commissioned and dedicated to my friend and colleague Carlo Failli, a clarinet professor in Mascagni Institute in Legorno. Here, a bass clarinet multiphonic chord sequence is rendered by two slightly different sound toolkit clarinet instruments according to interplay of real virtual or natural artificial IOF in use. Because I describe this patch, it is necessary to anticipate some words, because the sound instrument has been realized using two simple occurrences of sound to key clarinet code, importing them in OpenMusic as user-defined classes, following the very clear documentation. You have the documentation to this link. And this window contains the contents of the class SDK1. I have named it in this way. And also for SDK2. For visualizing it, you must follow Windows, Library, Menu, User, Chroma User. Sorry. Oh. And SDK1. And this is the content of the class. And the CSound code is inside it. This is the code for a first instrument, sound toolkit clarinet instrument. These are the codes for the very simple, of course, two instruments. The only difference is expressed by red lines. I added, because I didn't like the result in first instrument, so I added the simple amplitude envelope, the out of the second instrument. Please note, OpenMusic can give a sound synthesis error when you use SDK opcodes, because it is necessary to define raw wave path environment variable. So you must go inside preferences, externals, CSound, options, and in this box you must add the correct line for the folder that contain raw waves. Now it's not set, so if I synthesize the sound inside OpenMusic, I receive an error. But I will use the pre-made examples. Well, turning to my patch, this part of the patch, bass clarinet multiphonic chord sequence analyzed and generated in Audio Scout is imported, reading the SDIF file, and converting the data in a real music notation chord sequence. This part of the page is devoted to the generation of random SDK clarinet code parameters for its controllers, that is stiff noise, LFO, LFO depth, and breadth. The user can choose, can define minimum and maximum value, and each chord will have always different parameters for these controllers. This part of this page contains a sub-page I copied from tutorials for the conversion from chord sequence to M-chroma parameters. I added only multiplication factors for stretching, transposing, or varying the duration of each chord at music notation level. These are the two instruments. And then there is the synthesis, the result. I would like to proceed to listen to the second example, the instrument of the amplitude envelope. These sounds are not directly used in the piece and the composition, but became the source for further sound developments. This is the SDK2 matrix content, because these instruments are in substance are matrices. And so in first slot you have the onsets, the durations, the amplitude, the pitches, and the last five slots are relative to SDK clarinet controller parameter values. A decision is a sound file generated by dispatch with the beginning and the end of the score. The second patch was used in composing Fabula for baritone sax, electronic sounds and live electronics, a piece commissioned and dedicated to Giampaolo Anton Girolami that we will have the pleasure to listen to in this afternoon concert. Here sound is spatialized with very rapid, accelerando or rallentando motions, causing disintegration or aggregation of the sound, a sort of sound granular synthesis obtained by fast spatialization. This because the piece is founded on also on autobiographical elements by Giampaolo and me and mine. So this is a way to symbolic remember, represent the dramatic last Central Italy earthquake. It's a sort of earthquake in spatializing the sound. This first part of the patch has the input sound. In this case, it is sax multiphonic. The sub-patch contains object from one Super BP library for stretching or transposing in an independent panel the audio file before the spatialization process. One Super BP library is a translation of AudioSculpt software inside Open Music. This part of the patch is for the generation of rallentando accelerando motions, so the user can select the first or second curve, and because are selected Y breakpoint functions coordinates, here you have rallentando, here you have a slow accelerando. This part of the patch is for the random generation of coordinate point values. Here you have 801 point for a total of 800 trajectory segments. So the result is can be something like this, a sort of trajectory surface. VBAP trajectory is the OM Prisma library function for spatialization. The setup is a quadraphonic one. Here you have the synthesis. We can listen to rallentando example. For generating the sound, you in Open Music, for the result, you must select the last object of algorithm chain and press V on the keyboard, computer keyboard. It's a little long process, so I have also already realized it. This is the result. You can listen to the effect. It will be necessary to tune this patch with this ambient, but there is no time for that. Here, second curve is selected with accelerando motion. I am ending the. Changing the curve, you obtain different results. And this is the generated orchestra, very long file, with the instrument, the user-defined codes, and the score that contains many other lines. So, to summarize, use of codex in the sound encourages the coupling with the algorithmic composition software for developing scores. There is a long tradition in Open Music with observe the libraries. So you can unite the symbolic levels and musical notation level with the electroacoustic composition level, with the advantage of the fact that you can use all algorithmic composition tool at the disposal inside Open Music. And very promising, in my opinion, is the possibility to include ONSI sound instruments in OMM Chroma as user-defined classes, not only for enriching the set of instruments, but also for rebuilding historical documented sound instruments. So, if you like, this is only the beginning of the work. Thank you. Here you have my courses site, Italian English version, at the page conferences and seminars. You already have this slide in PDF format, my YouTube SoundCloud channel, and my contacts. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you.